Here we go!
Woohoo! Yahoo!
Peachy!
Okay, I'm gonna win!
Oh look, it's Mario and his good friends! But it looks like something's wrong! What could it possibly be? They're talking about who among them is the biggest star, the superstar! A superstar must be strong, says Wario. Donkey Kong's got bragging rights for strength! Or perhaps Mario would make the best superstar! Or maybe the Princess Peach! But wait, we can't forget Yoshi with all of his energy! Why, they're all arguing, each one claiming to be the superstar! Does each of you really want to be a superstar? Then let me see what it takes to become a superstar. Does it only take strength to be a superstar? In order to be a superstar, it takes courage and wisdom and... kindness. If all of you want to be a superstar, then I have an idea. Why not use the warp pipe in Mushroom Village and head out into adventure? The person who comes out of the adventures on top is the superstar. I have to tell you, there's no telling what kind of danger might await you. Do you want to head out into adventure? This is a gentleman, the Radical Gameplay here, playing Mario Party for the Nintendo 64, everybody, and welcome, everybody. And I just want to tell you all, first off, this is the first Mario Party that started it all within the Mario Party franchise, the first ever Mario Party for the Nintendo 64, the Mario Party that started it all, everybody, released in 1998 by Nintendo, and with Hudson Soft as partnered up. As this is the first Mario Party released for the Mario Party franchise, everybody. And I just want to tell you all, everybody, Mario Party has been a game that I have played back in my childhood, everybody. And I just want to say I played this as a child on my Nintendo 64, and I kept playing it with my friends. And I played it with my friends on the Nintendo 64, and I just want to say... Mario Party will forever be my jam, everybody, as this has given me so much spirit and so much motivation within gaming history of my life, and I just want to say this game will always forever be in my heart to start off all with, everybody. Now, we're going to get started through, as what we just have watched, we have watched the opening introduction of Mario Party, everybody, as we are going to get started into a series of Let's Play for Mario Party, everybody, and we're going to get started with today's video, everybody, and now... And now, okay, now here's the thing. A while back, I have did a series of Let's Play for Mario Party on my channel, but here's the thing. The reason why I'm going to be redoing this series of Let's Play for Mario Party, everybody, is because of better quality and better commentary for within my channel, everybody, as I want to do this with better quality on my channel, better HD quality on my channel, and better commentary going through within this series of Let's Play for Mario Party. Now, I've been wanting to do this series of Let's Play in HD for Mario Party for a while now. It's just I wasn't sure if today was the right time, as I've been wanting to do this for a while now, so that way I can get more views onto my channel, hopefully, as I really wanted to do this for a while now. I want to do the Mario Party franchise. I want to do a series of Let's Plays for within the Mario Party franchise, and I've wanted to do this for a while now. And I'm happy to doing this for all of you people, everybody, and now... With that said, we're going to get started within today's video, everybody. And now, with that being said, let's get started with today's video as we're going to redo this series of Let's Play with Mario Party with better quality, better commentary on my channel. Alright, now, for today's video, we have just watched the opening introduction for Mario Party. And now, for today's video, for our series of Let's Play for Mario Party, we are going to be going into the first part of the Adventure Board. As we are going to be going into the first Adventure Board, the first half of the Adventure Board, which is DK's Jungle Adventure, everybody. Now, we're going to go into DK's Jungle Adventure, but originally, when I did my first series of Let's Play for Mario Party original, in the original one, as we have did Mario's Rainbow Castle, and now, DK's Jungle Adventure is literally the first adventure board to be going through within Mario Party, not Mario's Rainbow Castle, because that was supposed to be later within the game, everybody. Alrighty, now we are just going to get started within today's video, and we are going to go into DK's Jungle Adventure within today's video, everybody. And now, with that being said, I'm so happy to be doing this for all of you people, and I hope you all like today's video. And now, let us get started, and here we go. Okay, now, but before we start the video, everybody, here is what I want you people to do. Please don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content, and click that notification bell icon, that way you people will never miss a video that I post on my channel. I'm the Real Gold Game Player, and my name is Jared, and I upload every Monday through Friday 2 videos a day onto my channel. And with that said, I just want to tell you, everybody, I have over 2,000 videos, and if you all want to go look onto my channel, be my guest. I have a whole lot of videos for all of you wonderful people to look at on my channel. I have a whole lot of content for all of you people to look. And now, and not only that, I'll be asking you a question at the end of this video. And with that being said, let us get into Mario Party and begin. As we are going to begin the part, as we are going to get into the party within today's video, everybody. And now... we're going to be playing this on my Nintendo 64, and within the Nintendo 64 controller is we press the start button to start the party. Alright, now everybody, we are just getting our adventure started, and I want to clarify, I'm literally playing Mario Party on the original Nintendo 64 console, using an AverMedia Live Gamer Mini combined with a Nintendo 64 HDMI adapter, which I gotten off of Amazon. And I just want to tell you all, I was just trying to test this recording before I move on to my series of Let's Play for Mario Party. But it turns out it was a total success, as everything works perfectly with no lag whatsoever. And we are just about to get into the adventure started right now. All right, now, where we are exactly is this is the hub world for Within Mario Party, everybody. This is the hub world as we are in the Mushroom Village, everybody, within Mario Party, as this is where the game starts here and now, everybody, and now. Now, by using the control stick, you will point into different areas of the control stick. As we have a few options. This is a mushroom shop. You can buy items here, and we go to the bank to see how many stars or coins that we have total or items. And we have our option house. We can choose the game settings however we want here. And this is the mini game house, and we check to see. And this is where we check our mini games, and we can play our mini games as many times as we want, as long as we have the mini games for it. And we have the mini game raft, and we have the raft, which takes us to mini game island, which is optional, but we're not gonna get started into within going to mini game island. As what we are going to do is we're going to go into completing this entire series of Let's Play of doing all adventure boards in one go, everybody, within this series of Let's Play for Mario Party. Okay, now, I forgot to mention one thing. By pressing the start button on your Nintendo 64 controller, you get to check the item list, which we have a coin box in. When pressing the left or right by pressing on the control stick, then you will see the current standings on the adventure board. And we haven't even played any of them, as you can see, everybody. And we have our coins, which we have 300 coins, and that is for going into the mushroom shop. And for the stars, we have 0, and we get the stars into the adventure boards as collecting them as many stars as we go. Hawaii, we are in that adventure board, and now we unpress the start button, and we're going to go into the warp pipe to start our adventure, everybody. And now, like I said, everybody, for today's video, we are going to be going into the first adventure board, as we are going to be going into the first half of going through within DK's Jungle Adventure, as we're going to be doing 10 turns. As we're going to be doing 10 turns of going through within DK's Jungle Adventure for the first half of this video, everybody. As what we are going to do is, I know that a lot of you people have played Mario Party, but we're going to do 20 turns for each and every adventure board. As we're going to play half through within each and every adventure board onto this series of Let's Play for within my channel. That way it will be balanced. I'm going through within my series of Let's Play for Mario Party, but now we're gonna get the adventure started as we press the A button. And okay, now you have the choice: we depart for adventure or hear the game rules. But a lot of you people have played Mario Party, so we're gonna get the adventure started, and we're gonna get the party started. Alright, now everybody, this is where we get to choose our character and the game settings, and we have to answer questions, and we have to set up how we want to play this game. First, we select how many people we want to play, and we're going to be playing the one player, everybody, and we get to choose the characters. And now we have a selection of choosing which characters we want to play with. 6 characters, which is Mario, Luigi, Peach, Yoshi. Hold on. Yoshi, Wario, and Donkey Kong. Alright, now for DK's Jungle Adventure, we're going to be playing with Donkey Kong, everybody. Now, to clarify, each and every single character has their own adventure board and named after themselves. Yes, we're going to play with, and once we select the first player that we're going to be selecting, we get to select other characters too. As we're going to play with Donkey Kong, and we're going to play with Mario, Luigi, and Wario for the first time within this video. And now we're going to select, and for our selection, we get to select normal players for all the other characters. Okay, and now we're going to select our map where we are needed to go. And we have the option to select using our control stick, everybody, as to selecting the map where we are needed to going. But we are needed to going to DK's Jungle Adventure because that is the first one we are needed to going into. Now, originally, I have done Mario's Rainbow Castle, the first one in my old series of Let's Play for Mario Party, but turns out DK's Jungle Adventure is the first one we are needed to going into. Okay, now we are used to our star power to find the secret of the ruins. The map difficulty is 1 star, and 1 star is supposedly the easiest. And now for the final setup, we are going to choose the number of turns we'll play. Okay, now we are going to be selecting 20 turns as we're going to be going into 10 turns. This is where we select how many turns that we're going to be doing. We're going to be going into 20 turns and then we're going to be going into 10 turns and we're going to be doing 10 turns in the next video. All right, now we're going to select the last question, and when the settings are good, and we are going to get the party started. Here goes! DK's Jungle Adventure! And well, here is everybody. Welcome, everybody. I'm your guide, Koopa Troopa. Here in this jungle stand the mysterious ruins. Rumor has it that a great treasure is hidden here. If you look for this treasure, surely one of you will find it. But beware, there are many traps in this jungle. Whatever you do, don't step on the question mark spaces, as your safety cannot be guaranteed. Now then, let's decide turn order. Alright now everybody, for this part we are needed to press the A button to roll the dice in. Now the turn order has been decided and I get to go last. First is Mario. Second is Luigi. Third is Wario. Fourth is DK. That will be the order of turns. Last, a present from me. 10 coins for each of you. I hope they will be of some use. Now, let's start, everyone. Shoot for the stars and good luck. Let me show you where to find the first star. This is the star spot. Get the star by giving Toad 20 coins. Okay, now everybody, now probably pressing the start button, you get to pause the game while we are going through within this adventure bar. Now let me pause for a second now, everybody. Now the game's objective for us is to be becoming the superstar, as we need to obtain the most star for that person to obtain the most stars within Mario Party. And that's the game's objective. As now, for Mario Party, within this game, everybody, the games is based on luck, everybody. If you are, a lot of people will know that, everybody. Now, I want to going through within this series of Let's Play as we're going to go into save settings, and what we're going to do is we're going to save after every turn because it doesn't automatically save. It doesn't automatically save within Mario Party, as you have to manually save the game within the save settings, everybody. And now we are going to go back into within this, and we are going to, and we're going to press the start button in. And Mario is up on the first, and now, everybody, now for the coins that we have 10 coins, and that is for buying such as taking a path, taking a different path, as you will have to pay coins for a certain event of the sort. And now we are just going to get into the party started. And now a lot of you, I know that a lot of you people have played Mario Party, but there is just some things I have to explain to everybody, as there are one-player minigames. There are one-player minigames that one-players can win coins for themselves. And now, just to clarify, once everybody already has went into going into doing their own turn, once everybody's turn is up, then we do a four-player minigame at the end. But now we're just going to witness this is the funniest game that has ever to come within this part of this video, within this part of this game, as Wario gets stabbed on his big butt of his. As Wario gets a big splinter in that big butt of his. Alrighty, now Wario has gotten 20 coins. Now Wario has gotten 10 coins in. We are just rolling into the dust of the sort, as Wario is getting more greedier as he won 10 more coins. And now it's my turn to go, and oh my gosh, I landed one, and that does it. Okay, now one is the lowest that you can roll, and now we are just about to getting onto this turn, as we are going to go into this. As we're going to go into the four-player minigame, and we're going to be playing Running of the Bulb. Okay, now what we are supposed to do as this is basically a teamwork game, a teamwork minigame, as the game is basically, now there are minigames that we are needed to play to be going forward with and through the adventure board of Mario Party. And the whole purpose of Mario Party is basically based on minigames and luck of the whole sort. But now, a lot of you people have played Mario Party, but what we're going to do is we need to get to the light bulb. As we are needed to gain to the light bulb to the goal, everybody, as we are needed to guard Luigi. As we are needed to guard the person with the light bulb. This can be tricky, and what we are needed to doing is we need to absolutely. Oh my god, come on! Okay, now that was really a terrible first. There was a really terrible first go in. Okay, I just want to say I do not like this minigame of the whole sort, because it's really hard to control of trying to attack the ghosts. It's sometimes hard to control that. And now we are just about to be on our next turn, and okay, now when we are now on the next turn, and we are and what we are going to do is we are needed to going to playing this until it says turn 11, and that's when we are going to be done within this video, everybody. That's how we're going to get done, everybody. And now, I just want to say to all of you, it's a long way before we get done of going through within this video, everybody, because we have a lot to be going forward into. And now it's my turn, and hopefully I get a big one in. I got 8 of the whole sort in. Now, unless if you get 10 coins, then you can't go that way. But now we just gotten through that turn, everybody, and now Musical Mushroom, the next minigame is Musical Mushroom, and we are just gonna get into more of the party started. Basically, this is a game of musical tears, but this time it's with mushrooms on it. When the music stops, it's a dash, and we have to be the first one to jump and get the chest in the center mushroom. And these are the controls, and I don't really have to explain the controls to you, since a lot of you people know how to play Mario Party, and well, now it's time. And we just have to make sure until the music stops, and it's a dash. Okay, the music stopped in. Nope. Oh, come on. Because of that mushroom in the way, I could not get to the chest in time, because That mushroom in the way. I did not get to the chest in time. So far, I'm losing because of that. However, we have a lot more turns to be going before this game ends here, and so far I'm the runt of the litter right now. All right, but we still have a long way to go, everybody, as we do not have any stars yet. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to at least get a whole lot of coin. As we're gonna try to get the stars or the coins in. But however, Wario has literally gotten the upper hand of getting more coins in. He only gotten 3 coins! Oh, come on! Okay, now. Oh no! Well. Okay, now I just wanted to tell you all, everybody, when you land on the mushroom space, everybody, exactly. Then you either if you get a mushroom or if you get a poison mushroom, hold the phone, folks, and
welcome to the Bowser Space. We have plenty of fun events. Now then, choose your event by roulette.
All right, now let us to see if it's bad or if it's good. And okay, Bowser's Balloon Burst, and
it's Bowser's Balloon Burst. Play a mini game and it's fun effect. But the rules are a little different from usual. Everyone who loses 10 coins. Well, here we go.
All right, now everybody, Balloon Burst is now for Balloon Burst is one of the original mini games, but this time, if anyone loses, then they will lose 10 coins. Now A and Z buttons are the buttons you have to press to pump air and to pump on the pump and retract it. I don't know how to explain. You just have to put air into the Bowser balloon until he pops. Here goes nothing. And now to clarify, you just have to have a good rhythm of doing balloon bursts, because you just have to have a good rhythm of pressing the A and Z buttons. The A and Z buttons are a better alternative of blowing air into the Bowser balloon. And if I can get it right, I just won the Bowser mini game. Well, lucky me.
Now for the results. Mario and Luigi and also Wario lose 10 coins. Well, see ya. Toad, come back.
Well, now, everybody, it looks like I am getting the upper hand. And now, everybody, now we are going to be playing a 1v3 minigame. Now, if one person is... One person's player's color is red, and the other players are blue colored, then it's a 1v3 game. Now, it varies depending on what we're going to do. Now, for this, we're going to be playing the Coin Block Bash, as this is a coin game. All right, now I have the hammer, and basically I have a hammer, as what we are going to do is we need to bash those blocks, everybody, as I need to bash those blocks in. This time I get the upper hand this time, and now we press the start button, and I need to make sure I get away from all those people. And I have to absolutely make sure I... Oh, seriously? Oh no. Oh no, come on. Oh great. Okay, now that's not good. And look at that, I got more coins this time, man. Oh! Now the question is, how many coins did I get of the whole sword? I hope I got more than anyone. Whoa, look at that! and I got 8 coins out of all the other characters. Well, this time I'm in the lead by 2 coins this time. Bravo! Now, this is what I call a party this time. All right, now we are on the next turn, everybody. And now let me... And now if we can get things going in... And now Mario steals my coins. And well, what a surprise that is. And oh my gosh, and... And he stole, and he stole 7 coins from me. Come on, seriously? And Mario literally gets the upper hand as Mario gets literally gets the star this time. That's whatever. Okay, Mario gets the star. Good. Okay, now this is really turning out a bear. This really is not a good party so far. Yeah. All right, now we get to witness to know where the next star is going to be at a time like this. And now that's where the next star is going to be. All right, now, okay, now let me just see which turn we are on. We are on turn 4 as of right now, and we're going to try to at least. Okay, now everybody, now to clarify, once you go through an entire lap around the whole adventure board or in an area of the adventure board, then you will get 10 coins from Koopa as you did a full lap around it. And now it's my turn, and we get 3 spaces this time. And now we're going to be playing another 4-player minigame, and we're going to be playing Facelift. And now I just wanted to say, everybody, Facelift is a really weird game, everybody, as what we are going to be doing, we're going to be tugging Bowser's face. This is one of the weirdest mini games I've ever seen in my whole life within Mario Party of the whole sort. And but now a lot of you people played Mario Party, but we're going to give Bowser a taste of his own medicine. All right, now I'm on the bottom here, and I'm going to have a little bit of trouble. Of the whole sort, is what we are need to doing is we need. Oh no, 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 no. Okay, now. And now we are needed to move the eyebrows. And hopefully I matched up everything, and hopefully I know what I was doing, and I got 98, everybody, and I am just getting things started. I'm on a roll today now. And now I got 25 coins total. And now, well, I am in second place right now. That's a good thing. Hopefully this party ends in a good note. That doesn't end on a sour. Hopefully this party does not end on a sour note, everybody. But now we are just getting more. We're just getting things started even more, and hopefully I am going to attempt to getting to winning this. And now it is done. My turn to go, and we gotten ourselves a 10, and we gotten ourselves 10 more coins from Koopa, and. And now we have the option to checking the map, everybody, with the controls, as there are arrows, we get to choose what we can decide, and we press the A button to go this way. And now we are going to go into this path, and we are going to... And would you look at that? We are going to go up this way because the reason why is because we have 2 spaces, and not only that, we get to play a 1-player minigame. And what is that minigame going to be, everybody? And that game is going to be Ground Pound. And okay, now I just want to tell you all, everybody, we have witnessed Wario playing Ground Pound not too long ago, everybody. And what we are supposed to do is we are supposed to guess which one is the flat top post. as we are supposed to ground pound on those, and A and Z buttons are to ground pound. For some reason, it's called hip dropping. And what are we just, and what we just witnessed, we literally know which ones we are supposed to ground pound as we needed a glimpse. Oh no, that was accidental. I meant to ground pound this one, and as we have 30 seconds to doing this, and just like this, and oh come on, seriously, and
finish.
10 seconds to spare. It did not take us that long at all, and we're good to go! By that being said, we gotten ourselves 10 more coins to be going through, and hopefully we can go through within this, everybody, as we are going to be going into another 4-player minigame, everybody. And now, what is that minigame going to be? Mushroom Mix-Up! Okay, Mushroom Mix-Up is... Mushroom Mix-Up! Okay, now for this minigame, as the mushrooms will sink down once... Okay, once Toad selects the color that you people have to be on, then the other mushrooms will sink as well. As if you're too slow, the mushrooms will sink. It will sink into the ocean, and now we're gonna get this started in... Oh my gosh! Okay, now there's a whole lot of other colors that we can get on here, and we just got on black and of the whole sort, and okay, whoa, my God, would you just look at that, and oh my gosh, and literally Mario just ground pounded on me, and he bounced off me, and he fell into the ocean. Oh my gosh, this is a game that I do not like in some ways, and oh my god, he just bounced off, Wario just bounced off of Luigi, and really, no, oh my god, stupid controls, that was just wrong, seriously, because of the stupid controls, well, on the good side, literally, we did not lose any coins. And nobody won, but anyway, we're pretty much even. Alrighty, now we're on the next turn, and we're going to attempt to become the superstar as we are attempting to getting the next star. Hopefully, as nobody else gets the other star, as nobody else can get the other star other than me, it has to be me. And if I can't roll a 10, then I am entirely successful and somewhat successful. And now I trade in 20 coins and come to Papa, and you are officially mine. You are officially mine. Rumored has it that the treasure is a banana made of gold. Did you know that?
Yeah.
And now everybody, Toad is going to show us where the next star is, and he's literally right under my nose. Oh my gosh, of all the places, it has to be right there. And now we landed on the mushroom space, and we get to go on much more further, and we get to take 5 more spaces, and we are going to steal more, and we're going to steal coins from Luigi. And so far we are getting up there. And we gotten ourselves some coins in. And we are now just about to end this turn right here, and we are now going to be going into a 4-player minigame, and we're going to be playing Treasure Divers. Okay, now Treasure Divers is a coin minigame, everybody, and we're going to go underwater for deep sea diving for treasure, as we're going to be the pirates around here this time. Now the A button repeatedly is to dive and is to swim, and using the control stick is to move.
Start.
And we gotta watch out for the sharks that's lurking underneath the water this time. And oh my gosh, and that's not good. And we literally just got hit by a blooper, and we need to absolutely be precautious of what we're hitting in. And now I just wanted to clarify, there is time how much that we can spend underwater before we go back up into the surface, and we got some more treasure, and we need to make sure we watch out for all the bloopers. Oh my gosh, and that is not good, and that's not what I wanted to do, and whoa! Oh, come on, seriously? And who's going to get that treasure? Who's going to get that treasure chest up in the surface? And it's Luigi! And I'm not sure how many coins I've gotten amongst of all the other characters, and it turns out I got 11 coins! Well, I got more than the other ones, and I'm in first place right now! Good! Well, so far we're getting back up there. So far we're getting up ahead of the other characters, and now we're going to go on the next turn, which is turn 7 right now. Now to stopping of going through within this video, we are going to go up until where it says 11 turns, where it says turn 11 in. And it turns out Luigi's not going to steal my coins, and he decided to go for Mario's head on the list of him stealing coins from Boo. And now it is time for us to getting the party started around here with today, everybody. And now we are near to rolling the dice once again in. Now, let me see. Now, by pressing the B button, you have the option to know which way you are going in. Okay, now, yeah, if we start from the red space, and... or if we go this way, and... Nah, it makes no difference. We're gonna go down here, and... we're gonna land right there, and we are going to go into another floor player minigame, everybody. And now, we're going to go into... hot rope jump! This time we're going to be burning our butts off, along with Wario's big butt right there. Wario's definitely going to get his butt burned off this time, buddy, with his big butt of his. And now we're going to be doing a hot rope jump. It's basically jump rope, but this time it's going to be much harder than you realize. Much harder than you think. Alright, now for the hot rope jump, we are needed to doing over 20 jumps this time, as we need to absolutely timer jumps on how we are going to go and how we're going to jump rope here, as we are needed to absolutely, as we are needed to make sure we are needed to timer jumps, and the jump rope will go faster and faster within this minigame, everybody, and we need to be sure that we can get through with this without burning our butts off. I'm sure that Wario will burn his butt off.
Finish.
And well, it turns out Wario did not get his butt burned off this time. Well, wasn't sure what the outcome was going to be, but it turns out we gotten through the minigame, and now we're moving on to the next turn here. Okay, now the next turn has come to pass, and we are now just needed to going on to this next turn to see if we can get that next star within this next turn, everybody, and now... well, it looks like Mario's gonna get the next star at this sort of time, and hopefully we'll get the next star before anything else happens. Well... That depends after Mario gets that star, and, well, it's most likely Mario is going to get that star, and this is where Wario gets to go into this next turn, and, nothing happened. Okay, now the green space is happening space, which a lot of you people know that, and if you land on a happening space, something can happen or something will not happen. But now it's my turn, and it's time for us to be going into this turn, and to end this turn, and we did it, and now another four-player minigame. We're going to be playing a four-player minigame, and now this next minigame is going to be Crazy Cutter. As what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to cut the fossilized characters free. As what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to trace along the line of the fossilized characters. And which is simple, we need to use a control stick to move, and we need to trace it. And this game can be pretty difficult. I'm talking about getting 100% as see what I'm doing. I'm doing okay, but I'm not perfect. But anywho, I'm tracing down on the line, and we are now for the points that we need. We are needed to getting above 80 points of trying to complete this mini game, and we are just about to
finish.
Out of all the people, basically, if you get over 80 points, basically everyone wins. Welp, like I said, basically everyone wins, and so far I'm in the lead for now. And now we are just getting more of the party going on forward, and Mario literally gets the next star, and at this rate, he'll be the superstar in no time. And now we are just now ready to move on to see where the next star is going to be. Where is the next star going to be? And oh, the star is going to be right there. And we need to go over there before any other characters go over there. And this one may be easy depending on which character can get ahead of me. And I am not sure what's going to happen of the whole sort. And, it turns out Wario gets to steal him. Wario gets to steal. Oh, my God. Wario only gets one coin in. Oh, my gosh. Well, that's what you get for being too greedy of the kind, Wario. But anyway, it's time for me to going on to this next turn in. We are just about to going into this next turn as we are just about to end this next turn here as we get to play Bombs Away within the next minigame of the whole sort. As we need to survive to the end. As we are needed to survive to the end by pirates from Bowser himself in. And well, would you look at that? It turns out Mario and Wario is out of the picture of the whole sort, and we need to make sure if we can just do this in the next 15 seconds or so, then we are good to go, and we know! Whoa, that was so close! The cannonball literally just aimed at me, and hopefully, and literally, I literally just survived, and
finish!
And we entirely survived to the end! We have managed to survive to the end, and so far I have 65 coins as of right now, and we're getting more of the party in. All right, now the next turn has come, and we're going to see. And now, okay, to clarify, this is going to be our last and final turn for within the first half of the 10 turns in. We are going to absolutely end the video after this next turn here, and we're going to just play it out to see where this goes from here in. And Mario is going to steal my coins. Let's just see how many coins Mario is going to. Oh, not bad, but. But preferably, I prefer not anyone to steal my coins, no matter what it is. And hopefully, I just want to say, hopefully this game does not end on a sour note. That's what I'm trying to get my point at. And now we're going to see if we can... We gotten ourselves seven spaces, and we are needed to absolutely go this way, and with that being said, we are just about to end this turn right here, and we are needed to absolutely going on to this final minigame for within the half of the 10 turns. Alright, now tightrope treachery is what we are supposed to do. We are supposed to balance on the tightrope. This can be tricky, as we are needed to balance ourselves with cannonballs being fired at us. We are needed to be careful on this one, as our top priority, this game can alter of the... As now this minigame can be altered because depending on the wind speed of this minigame, and we need to make sure nothing will knock me off. And so far, they're not doing a good job of trying to track me down. And as it turns out, we are just about to. And we are. Can we make it? We did it! We made it without getting us knocked off, and we are basically done here of the whole sort. And I've gotten 15 coins, and that's pretty much a wrap up for this. And now it's time that we are about to end this video right here. Alright, now with that being said. And now we just press the start button, and we are just about to be wrapped up within today's video, everybody. And we are just about to be done within today's video, everybody. And we just gotten through the first 10 turns of going through within DK's Jungle Adventure. And so far we have collected one star within this video, and we have... But however, our luck is coming on within this part of this video, and I've done bad earlier, but so far I'm doing better within this part. But anyway, we have watched the opening intro and at the very beginning, and we have gotten through within this part, everybody. And now we are just about to wrap up within today's video, everybody. And now, with that being said, it is time to end this video right here. Now, but before we end this video, everybody, it is time for me to ask you the question of the day within today's video, everybody. Now, everybody, here is the question of the day. What are your thoughts on Mario Party for the Nintendo 64? Do you love it? Do you hate it? What are your thoughts on Mario Party, everybody? Now, please leave me in the comment section for within today's video, and I hope you all like today's video, and I hope you all like what you see within this. And not only that, everybody, if you all want more content, please don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content. I'm Dorelco Gameplayer, and my name is Jared, and I upload every Monday through Friday 2 videos a day on my channel. And I just want to say to all of you people, I have over 2,000 videos. If you want to go look on all the videos that I have on my channel, be my guest. I have a whole lot of videos for all of you to look at, everybody, on my channel. And thank you for watching, everybody. And I will see you all in the next video for more Mario Party and other content on my channel. And thank you for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Love you all. Have a great day. See you next time. Peace.